friends, this is Dr. Divya and welcome to 10th Annual Pharmaceutical Leadership Summit and Pharma Leaders Business Leadership Awards. Today we are over here to discuss the Healthcare Roundtable, Fixing the Healthcare Chaos and Transforming Healthcare Delivery System. So let's get started. And still we are discussing about women empowerment, women rights, but we are ignorant about the most important aspect of women's life, that is women's health. We all know that women actually go through so many stages in life, and it's very important to address that aspect too. So we have Navamita in-house today. Let's discuss with her. Welcome, Navamita.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Navamita, as I very precisely said that, a woman has various stages in her life.
Yes.
She actually goes through a puberty, then actually enters into adolescence, then the reproductive age, and after that, menopause.
Yes.
But as a family or as a society in India, people really don't understand the importance of health in that sense.
Yes.
So what do you have to say about it?
Okay. Thank you so much for inviting me and letting me share. We just had a few interesting data, right? Right during the presentation, the doctor, Dr. Sharmila Mazumdar, she shared that it's the rural women who do not have, who have lesser sexual dysfunction than urban women. It's the rural women who seemingly have a better healthy relationship with their bodies than urban women. Isn't this highly contradictory? We believe we in urban India, we have access to medicine, we have access to infrastructure, everything. Yet it is actually the entire social structure which doesn't allow us to go and ask any question related to our health unless it's a it's a chronic disorder or it's a massive disorder wherein you need to hospitalize. You are not encouraged to talk about your well-being. You're not encouraged. I mean, you're actually looked down upon if you talk about mental health, right? We do not have any infrastructure for any kind of training towards a content life.
Correct.
Whereas in India, we have yoga, we have all the facilities, but where is the training?
We're talking about lifestyle, but we don't understand how important it is to be educate about the right lifestyle.
Absolutely. Essentially, we have these big program for POSCO and everything rolled out wherein kids are being they are being entirely educated on good touch and bad touch. Women are being educated on the kind of nutritive effects that would happen in their body in terms of their blood cells and all these things. But those are in the infrastructure level. On a daily, day-to-day level, on a daily basis, this entire generation.
Please, movement mat. Start. Navamita, as you rightly said, that the education is the key. And education at various levels are important.
Yes.
Like good touch, bad touch, you talked about.
Yes.
The same way, the various levels of adolescence, puberty, then the pregnancy, everything need to be taken care of.
Yes, yes, exactly. Interestingly, we are from the country of yoga. We are the country of Patanjali and we are the country of Kama Sutra too. But as it goes, theory remains theory, it doesn't become practice.
Correct.
Government has a lot of programs. The Ministry of Women and Child Development, they are doing so much. They have implemented 26 weeks for maternity. They have implemented the POSCO with the entire education system, informing kids about all these precautionary measures. But does that really solve it?
Correct.
It does.
Because as you rightly said that the government are doing a lot of things.
Yes.
But at the end of the day, are they really implemented at the ground level?
Yes.
That is the most important question
now. On a day-to-day basis, where exactly are we lacking? We have the entire training. We have the entire education system and we also have the solution.
Correct.
The medicines, the preventive options. We do not really need to go to that. We just need a proper system within wherein women are taught to take care of their body just as we are taught to get ahead of every the competition, get better at education, get better marks. We need to learn how to take care of our bodies too.
I think so, that will be the real empowerment as compared to the you know women right and empowerment we are talking about. If we are healthy, we are able to take care of ourselves, that will make us more refined.
Exactly. That's the entire base for empowerment, because no matter how many times I may learn how to vote right or how I may learn how to earn right, if I'm not well, the entire money goes only to a hospital, not to my family. So yes, these are the grassroots, and interestingly, 70% of India still lives in rural villages. 70% of India still to our thoughts may not have the kind of access that we have, yet they are ahead in terms of health because A, they do not have the right stress lifestyle that we do have in urban India, and B is obviously there is the entire social opening discussion, right? Mm-hmm. The joint families, the daimas who come and talk to women about
the communities need to be created so one can actually discuss.
Hugely, that entire support system which is there, that needs to be there. The entire isolation and the silo system of growth that we have in urban India, that needs to really worked out. That would I suggest, not just the medicine, not just the government part, but on a grassroots level, these are the changes that needs to come in.
See, it's just an iceberg phenomena happening. Everybody's saying that okay, there's good work being done by government.
Yes.
The steps taken by government are commendable.
Yes.
But again, implementing those steps are the key factor.
Exactly. I mean, interestingly, if you allow me, we had the Ministry of Women and Child Development, they ran a program called We Are Equal. That was during the International Women's Day. And the entire program had men talking about why they think they are equal. So that's the kind of approach that we need towards a woman's growth. A woman should own her growth, yes. It's the family around her, it's the village around her, it's the city around her who needs to own her well-being, her health, her economy. So
it was great and pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much.
Namrata.
Thank you so much.